Hello. This slope near the road is covered with three main groups of organisms. So you can see lots of white stuff, which are lichens. Lichens of Cladonia or similar genus. Also greenish masses. And among them, from place to place, you can see the mushrooms. It's a very interesting neighborhood. Easy to tell about these three groups of organisms. So likely many people say that mosses and lichens are more similar to each other than to mushrooms. However, this is not correct. Ecologically, yes, both mosses and lichens are photosynthetic structures which will thrive on these very bare places, like on a stone, on a bark, some empty surfaces which are not yet colonized by other plants. So they are first comers, and in that case typically lichens will come first and mosses will follow. But essentially lichens are much more similar to mushrooms. So mushrooms are fruiting bodies of Basidiomycetes. It is a group of fungi. So these bodies are made exclusively for the spore distribution. And if you see lichen more closely, you will find that parts of it are exactly like this spore-bearing part of the mushroom. So they will produce spores. They even have different color, kind of transparent yellowish brownish one, whereas the most of lichen is greenish white. So lichen essentially is a fungus with very interesting story. We can call lichens alternative plants. In geological history, we think that lichens appear on Earth almost simultaneously with true plants, mosses and ferns. And ancestors of lichens and true plants are very similar to each other in some way. So fungi went to the surface of Earth, to the land, almost simultaneously with algae. So both belong to this non-tissued eukaryotes. So they have nucleus but no tissues. And this immediately start to interact with each other. Fungi, for example, might want to eat algae because algae are primary producers and will take carbon dioxide from atmosphere and light from the sun. And fungi are kind of predators which will take either dead bodies or sometimes even living ones. So this was initial relations. But then fungi start to interact with algae in a more complicated way. Meanwhile, algae is likely to produce more and more complicated forms. And at some point, we start to call them mosses. So they start to be more complicated and they will race to the main stock of land plants. But interaction with fungi did not disappear. Many, many land plants still have interaction with mycorrhizal fungi. So fungi, for example, will give them plenty of water and will receive some organic compounds back. But this is only one way. There was a second way too. So fungi acquire some algae inside their body and use the ability of constructing the fruiting body to make kind of pseudo plant or alternative plant form, which is photosynthetic essentially, because within body of fungus this algae will perform exactly the same work as they do outside. So they will take light of sun, they will take water and produce carbohydrates which will be shared with a fungal component. So each lichen consists of two components, fungal and algal. So interesting is also how to compare their distribution, dispersion modes with mosses. Mosses are actually, well, don't do it very well because they have that curse of sex on the top of skyscraper, so they need water for fertilization, and so they cannot grow very tall. They need to be low to accept water. Lichens in their fungal component on other side can produce spores anywhere. So spores may be on the very top of their body, so they do not have that restriction. But they have another restriction. So alga and fungus are still very independent. So relations between alga and fungus in lichen body are kind of, well, friend-enemy relation. They're not exactly very friendly to each other. Sometimes, for example, algal cells are killed by fungus. So this is not a very nice, well, perfect symbiosis. It's good enough, so it works. So lichen is growing very slow, and when it's producing these fruiting bodies, they will distribute only spores of fungi, and that spore will germinate and will start to search the alga to initiate with symbiotic lichen body. Complicated. So lichens invented kind of alternative vegetative way of reproduction. So sometimes, and you see it quite well here, because some kind of conical shaped structures appear, and on the surface of these cones, there are kind of dust. So that dust are small pieces of lichen body, which consist of both fungus and alga. And this is a more perfect way. However, that way does not include any sexual process. And in that regard, it is not so well done as the sexual process of mosses. So as you see, there are plenty of pros and cons for both groups. So lichens are slowly growing, they do not easily distribute together, or they can distribute together but without sexual processes. Mosses, on the other hand, will need water, so they cannot grow very tall. So both groups are kind of, well, simultaneously compete each other, and lichens normally are, well, adapted better to grow without water, so this is why they frequently are first colonizers. But mosses will immediately follow them. Mushrooms, another case, they belong to different groups of fungi. So lichens are mostly made by ascomycetes, and mushrooms mostly made by basidiomycetes. There are exceptions on both sides. And idea of mushroom is just to make some spores to go more far away. So they made fruiting body out of mycelium, and on the surface of it, they will raise spore-bearing cells and then release spores. So that part also present in these lichens. So there are mushrooms, lichens, and mosses on this wet slope nearby Mizuwa River. This is a west of Kyoto, and today is October 18. Thank you.